The MVP value only affects your length reading. It has no impact on your near and crosstalk, incision loss, return loss, or any other frequency-based measurements, not even propagation delay or delay skew. The MVP value tells the tester how fast the signal is traveling down your cable at 10 MHz. If we time the signal to see how long it takes to get to the end of the cable and back, we can calculate the length of the cable. Are you ready for some math? NVP is calculated by taking the speed of the signal in your cable and dividing it by the speed of light in a vacuum. A typical value for a signal in a cable may be 207,000 kilometers per second. The speed of light in a vacuum is 300,000 kilometers per second. That gives us an MVP of 0.69, or 69% in this example. There are three ways to set the MVP in the DSX cable analyzer. Entering the value is the simplest way. From the home screen, tap where your cable type is, tap Edit, and where you see MVP, tap, and then using the arrows, change the value to your desired value. Once you're happy with that, tap Done, Save, Use Selected, and now you're ready to begin testing. Another way is to measure the MVP of the cable. You'll get a length of cable that's at least 30 meters or 100 feet, longer the better. Physically measure it and note that value. Terminate the cable with a jack at each end and connect using the permanent link adapters. And then from the home screen again, we'll tap where our cable type is, Edit, and tap MVP again. And in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, you'll see Measure. So we'll tap Measure. Now in this case, with my MVP set at 69%, it thinks the length is 90.8 meters. Actually, the length of my link is 88 meters. So I'm going to change the length so it says 88 meters. And you'll notice the MVP value is also changing at the same time. So actually, the measured MVP of this cable is 66.9%. Tap Done, Save, and Use Selected. The final method is to choose one from the cable library. So again, from the home screen, tap your cable type, Edit, and where you see cable type, tap More, and you'll see manufacturers at the bottom here. I'll randomly pick, say, Belden, and this one here. And you'll see the MVP value changes to 70%. When you change the cable type in the library, it looks up our database that's in the tester and presents you with the value that's in there. Tap Save, Use Selected, and you'd be ready to begin testing. So there are three options to setting the MVP. Looking up the MVP on the cable's vendor's website and manually entering that value is by far the best method. Vendors do change their cables, and there is always the possibility that the library in your DSX is one version behind. Also, if an audit of your results is being conducted, chances are they will use the value of the datasheet, not what you measured.